to episode 49 of the Arctic Knitting Podcast. My name is Emilia and I am, as always, coming to you from the northern part of Norway. And every time I say that, I look out the window. I don't know why. As if I think that I'm just suddenly somewhere else. But no, I'm still here in winter wonderland, which isn't always wonderful. Anyway, my name is Emilia and I live in the northern part of Norway, and this is not going to be a normal episode because I have been attending my first big yarn festival ever. I've been to Edinburgh, and well, yeah, I'm going to talk about that. It was so totally amazing, and I am already almost counting days until next year, but I'm not sure about the date. And also, I'm planning to do Rhinebeck, Vogue Knitting Live, Bergen Knitting Festival, the Bergen Strikkefestival in Norge. I want to check out if there's anything fun going on in Finland this year, because last year I went to Bergen Strikkefestival or Bergen Knitting Festival, and most of Finland is actually closer to me than Bergen because I live so far north. So maybe if you know about anything fun going on in Finland this summer, fall, next spring, let me know. Anyway, I have been getting a lot of new subscribers since I went to Edinburgh, and I want to say thank you. Thank you for checking out this podcast, and badly, I hope you like it. And if you do, hit the thumbs up button, and if not, please feel free to move along to any other podcaster. There's tons of them out there. So, I'm going to start today with telling you about the festival, then I think I will put in the footage of the festival and do the festival haul at the end, but that might change. I'm not sure, I didn't do very good with vlogging, so maybe I will just put the vlog footage in the end of the movie, or I will put it in the beginning. I don't know, you just have to watch and see. Anyway, the first thing I want to say is a big, big, big thank you to everyone who made Edinburgh Yarn Festival as good as it was. And thank you to Mika and Joe and to Louise for arranging of the Knit British podcast, for arranging the podcast launch. It was absolutely lovely. Thank you to everyone I met, to everyone who came up and said hello to me because you watched my podcast. You're awesome. I can't believe how much fun it was to talk with everyone. It's like, I knew that this would be fun, but I couldn't even imagine it would be this good. Yeah, just, I don't know where to start. Let's just start with Tuesday. Tuesday, I traveled from home. I went with my friend Teresa. We traveled from our place. She lives just a few houses away from me, and I think we went at like 5 in the morning or something. Then we had a almost two hour ride to the airport. We took a flight from Narvik to Oslo, and from Oslo to Stockholm. And in Stockholm, we met up with our friend Lynn. When we arrived in Stockholm, we went to our gate, and then you got into like this little room, the waiting room at the gate. And that is when I realized that I was going to the knitting festival, because we got in there, the first thing we see is 5 people sitting there knitting. And Teresa is a little bit more like, oh yeah, she talks a little bit more with people than I do. So she just went up and asked them, are you going to knitting festival? And yes, they were. We talked a little bit, then we sat down, and every other person coming into that waiting area was a knitter. It was almost like being on a shorted knitting play. It was knitters everywhere and so many beautiful shawls. We then arrived in Edinburgh, like in the city, at 3 or 4 o'clock in the afternoon. And we went to the hotel, which was pretty close to Waverley Station, and it's in Princess Street, so if you were in Edinburgh, you were living quite like central. The apartment was really, really nice. We had rented an apartment. I knew that there would be 2 bedrooms, there were 3 of us. It was this big living room and big kitchen. It was bigger, the living room was much bigger than it is here in my house. The kitchen was new and amazing, and there was 2 bathrooms, which can't complain. And the bus stop was right outside the door, so in the morning I just had to walk out the door and 2 meters or something, and then there was the bus stop which took me to the festival. But when we arrived Tuesday, we were really, really hungry. We decided to just walk and see if we found some place to eat, and of course we did. We found a restaurant right across the street, so we didn't even have to go very far. Then we was going out to see, look around, but I was so tired. I felt like I was going to be sick, so I ate like half of my food, and then I just told them that I didn't even pay. I just told Teresa, can you please pay this for me? I have to go back to lay down. And I thought I was going to be sick, so I went to lay down and I slept until the next morning. And then everything was fine. I think I was just tired from traveling and I probably forgotten to eat or something. So Tuesday I didn't really get to see the city or do anything. Wednesday morning we met, we went out, we had breakfast, and then we went to meet Ellie of the Scandinavian podcast. We met her in a yarn store. I don't remember the name of the yarn store, so forgive me. And we went to three different yarn stores that day, which were all amazing. And I did actually manage to buy nothing, because I didn't have a... Okay, I had a little bit of a budget. It's not like I didn't have enough money, but it's like I didn't want to spend them before the festival. So I managed to buy nothing this day. Then we went out, we had a cup of coffee, and Lynn and Teresa went back to the apartment, and me and Ellie went to the last yarn store, I think. Yeah, we did the last yarn store without them. And then we went to the knit night at the bar Aqua. It was really nice. We were able to get some food, which we really, really needed. Teresa came back and joined us. I got to meet Amy of the Stranded Dye Work and Stranded podcast. I got to meet Carola of the Psychic Knitter, and I got to meet May, which was... These were all just amazing ladies, and I had so much fun talking with them. My only problem is, and I'm just going to put this out there in case anyone picked up on that, when I'm in a room with lots of people, my ears won't work. It's like I can't hear what people are saying, and I can't focus out one voice. And I know many people feel like this, and I think that I'm even worse, because I've been to the doctor and they told me that it's basically my hearing isn't very good. But it's okay, but every now and then it's like I just zone out, because it takes so much energy to listen to what people are saying. So if I zoned you out at some point during the festival, it wasn't because of you, it's just because, well, I couldn't hear you. But it was really nice, the knit night was really nice. We got to knit a little bit, chat a little bit, and eat, not at least. I walked back with Amy because she was close to me, which was really nice. And I ended up walking back with Amy several days, and it was really nice because we actually got to talk, just the two of us, and I got to know her a little bit, and it was so nice meeting her. Thursday was the festival day, which was, yeah, can you believe how excited I was in the morning? It's like I was late to bed on Wednesday, but I think it was up at 6 in the morning. I went to the shower, and then I just stood there waiting for the time to be enough so that I could leave. We had early access, so we was able to go in at 9, but at 8 o'clock I met in a Costa right across the street. I actually thought that I was meeting with Amy and Ellie of the... Yeah, I actually thought I was meeting them in the Costa, but I was meeting with Patricia. I thought everyone was going to meet her, I don't know what happened. But I met up with Patricia, I met up with Patricia of the Knitography podcast, which you should definitely check out if you're into sewing mittens and stuff. I met up with her and some friends, and we had breakfast, then we went over to the festival, and I didn't really buy anything on Thursday. I did buy one thing, which I'm going to show you later. This day I met Grace of Babbel's Traveling Yarns. I think I might mess up the days which I met people, because But I met Grace, and she was amazing. She was so much fun. And I think this day, it could be Friday, but she had like this gorgeous woven scarf that she had made herself. And today is the next Monday, so it's been a week. And yesterday I spent all day just sitting here on my sofa, just with my phone and just checking out looms like you do. So I'm kind of hoping that I will buy a loom, and I kind of hope that I won't, because I don't really have the time, but I really want to try it out. So we'll have to see what happens with that. I met Barbara of Knitting I Love and Isabel of Fluffy Fibers, which was really nice to talk with. I talked quite a bit with Isabel, and it was really nice to meet with her, and it's so nice to meet people and talk about knitting and everything else as well. We have, both of us have children, and we talked a little bit about kids and stuff. Then I met Mars of Hey Brownberry, and yeah, and I talked quite a bit with her as well, and she's amazing. And I never seen her podcast before, but it's on my list now of podcasts that I'm going to check out, and I know that I will love it because I loved her. So yeah, I also met Maria of the Ninja Chicken podcast, and I come so like, okay, you're going to make anything podcast. What to call it? Ninja Chicken. How awesome is that? I haven't actually watched that podcast either, but I definitely will. It was so amazing meeting people whose podcast I watched from before, but then I met lots of podcasters who has podcasts that I haven't been watching, and I really look forward to watching them because I know that I will love the podcast because I really love the person behind the podcast. Thursday night was the Big Knit night. It was in the festival area, in the Marquee, I think it's pronounced. It was like, they didn't have it last year, but it was like this big tent thing outside of the festival area. You could walk directly, you didn't feel like outside, but it's like, which had 500 seatings. Big Knit night was there, and it was really fun just to hang out, knit with 500 other people. Talk with a lot of other people. I talk with shitload of people basically. It was really amazing. Friday is when I did the most of the damage, and I didn't really talk very much with people just because I was busy spending my money. But I got to meet Katie of the Inside Number 23 podcast for the first time, and I think that was Friday, and she's amazing. I didn't get to talk very much with her because everyone wanted to talk with her, which I totally get because she's amazing, and I hope that I will meet her again next year or on a later occasion and get to talk more with her because she is, I know people say that she's just as sweet in real life as she is on a podcast, but it's like she was even better in real life. I really enjoyed meeting her. The only negative thing about the festival is that it didn't really have much food. It had like sandwiches and stuff, lots of cakes, and I'm not really big on cakes, but there is Asta, I think it's called, like a big supermarket thing next door, which also have McDonald's. And Friday, I think it was Friday, anyway, I went to McDonald's with Magdalena of the Wolf and Schaffer podcast and Anna of the Dunkelgrün podcast, which both are amazing podcasts that I have been watching for. Magdalena I've been watching for a long time, and Anna is quite new, I think. It isn't that long since I started up, but I have been watching her since, not since the beginning, but like since episode 5 or something. And both of them have really nice podcasts, which, so it was really nice to get to spend some time with them. A Friday night, it was this Kelly, I think it was called Kelly, I'm not sure, big Scottish party at the festival venue. I didn't have tickets for that, so I wasn't really sure what I was going to do. But then I was invited to hang out and eat with some friends, and it was really nice to just be a little bit more relaxed, knit and talk about knitting. And but at this point I was already quite tired, and I went back and went to sleep. And Saturday I did some shopping, but I spent most of the day in the podcast lounge. I think I was just completely worn out. I just hang around in the podcast lounge. I was talking with people. I met Kim of Kim Smith Happy, I think it's called, a podcast. I've been watching it for a little bit, but not very much, but she's really, really sweet. And I met Catherine of the Craft and Treats, which you're going to see from a haul that I met her. She's very, very generous, and I really, really like her. Not because she's generous, I really like her podcast. We had agreed to do a swap, and she brought so much more than I thought that she would, but I'm not going to complain about getting stuff. Yeah, well, basically, I just hang out in the podcast lounge. I was talking with people. I was just sitting there relaxing. I zoned out quite a bit because I couldn't hear what people were saying. Friday was insane. It was so much people. Then, after the festival ended, I think I went straight back to the apartment we had rented, and I just fell asleep. Or I was staying in there with my friends, just knitting and watching TV, and then went to bed early. Sunday, it was time to meet the Shepherdess. I wasn't really sure what this event was, but we went up there. I thought both me, Lynn and Therese was going, but then it turned out that Lynn had to go home Sunday. So I had a spare ticket, so Ellie, Scandinitz, came along with us, and we went to meet the Shepherdess. And it was basically just a smaller shopping area with lots of local, like, from animal to yarn people who did everything. I didn't buy anything Sunday, both because my budget broke Saturday, but also because I just wanted to sit in it. So I sat down at the table, me and Teresa, together with Hannah of Cafe Bookworm and May. And we just had a really nice time, and about 1 o'clock we went back to the city. Our apartment was pretty close to the train station, and Hannah was going to take the train while me, Teresa and May were meeting up with some others for dinner. So we basically we took the bus into the city, we put Hannah's luggage in our apartment, then May and Teresa took off to try oysters, and me and Hannah went to Primark so that I could go shopping for some clothes. Then we went to Costa and had coffee, and then we were ready for dinner. Hannah still had like 2 hours until her train left. Okay, because it was still 2 hours until Hannah's train left, we gave it a key to her apartment so we can hang out, and we were kidding around that she was going to steal all our yarns. And she didn't, so thank you so much for not stealing my yarn, Hannah. I'm not sure if Akta managed to not walk away with anything. But then we went to dinner. It was me, Therese and May, and there was a lot of skin there, and it Ninja Chickens and Hey Brown Barberry, and it was really, really nice to just sit down, relax, take it easy, talk about the festival, talk about our experiences, and already starting to talk about next year's festival and when we are going to meet again. And by the end of that dinner, I was so tired that we just went straight back to our apartment, packed our suitcases and went to bed, and on Monday we took the flight back home, which of course didn't work out quite as we wanted to, because we were going to leave at 1 in the, like, 1 p.m. and then we were going to be home at 10 p.m. I think. But then the first flight, the flight from Edinburgh to Copenhagen, because we had to go through Copenhagen, it was delayed, so we didn't catch our flight from Copenhagen to Oslo, and then we got put on a later flight, but of course we was too late for our flight from Oslo and home, so we got to spend 1 night in hotel in Oslo, but it was okay. We got free hotel, we got free dinner, and we got free breakfast, and we got to relax a little bit more before going home to everyday life. So it was okay. All in all, it was a really, really good festival. And Mars of Hebron Berry, she asked at the dinner last night what was the best thing about the festival, and I didn't really know what to answer, because everything is just a blur. But it was definitely all the nice people. It was meeting all the people and talking with so much people. And the best moments was probably the moments we got like that dinner, when we got just together, just a few of us, and sat down and actually managed to talk a little bit and get to know each other and realizing how much we have in common. And not just knitting, but at other aspects of life as well. And I feel like I went to Edinburgh and I had been watching some podcasts, but I didn't really know anyone. And I came home and I have so many new friends, and it's so amazing. And I can't wait to meet you all again, because you're amazing. time to talk about all this stuff. I managed to bring something home with me, of course. And I have it in this big bin on the floor in front of me, so if I... Yeah, you know why. And it's basically... it's going to come up in the order it's laying in, because there is no particular order in here. And I'm not even sure that everything from the same vendor is together, because... Well, basically I've been taking stuff out of the bin to check it out and snuggle up with it and just feeling the yarns. And then I've been putting it in there, and I've been taking it out to show someone and putting it in, and it's just, I'm going to put all of this up in my craft room. After I recorded this podcast, I have just been waiting. So, okay, let's start with this. I went to Baramu and I picked up a few skeins of sport weight yarn. 100% British spun, dyed in Yorkshire. 100% British wool spun and dyed in Yorkshire. I don't know how to pronounce. It's 160 meters to 116 meters to 25 grams, so it's like a sport weight DK there and there. And these are going to be color work project. I didn't really buy these. I was going to buy these six when the lady told me that I would get a better price if I bought 10, and of course I bought 10. I also got a free pattern for a strapping cowl that I can use with this yarn, but I don't think I will, because I'm actually planning a hat design with the yellow ochre, the ochre yellow, the black and the light grey, but I'm not sure because now I have five colors, but I'm planning on doing some designing with that. I also got this tote bag from them, or I didn't get it, I bought it, let's be real. I bought this tote bag, it is really cute, and in here I have, this is not from them, it's just from everywhere, all over the place, because I have been putting out there before I left that I really wanted to get some mini skeins, and well, I got some mini skeins. It's just, I'm going to finish my blankets. It's so many mini skeins in here, I'm not going to go through them. Some of them were from other dyers, like this one that I got from Amy of Stranded Dye Works. This one is from Dottir Dye Works, she gave me a few. It's, I think she spoke Norwegian, but I'm not sure. Yeah, I got some of those from like different dyers. I also got some people just coming up to me, giving me a few mini skeins because I've been watching my podcast. Thank you if you were one of those people. I also had some people that I had made arrangement in advance, either that they was going to give me some mini skeins or that we were going to do swaps. And I'm still planning on doing the swaps that I talked about before leaving. I just really need to get back to answering the Ravelry messages again, because the last week it's just been, I've been so tired. I also bought this from Sue Stratford. Because, you know, I have to buy something for Ludwig, and this was so cute. It's a set, it has the all the yarns and everything you need, and the pattern and everything, and this is what's inside of it. And when I came home and I packed up this and Ludwig saw it, he went completely insane. He took it and he ran away and he hid under a table. And then he opened the box and he was so disappointed that there wasn't a lion in here, it was just yarn. So I will need to make that lion soon, like everything else. I got these two from Kathleen of Croppen and Treats. And I love them, they look amazing. So this is 20, this is our special blend, I think. I'm not sure what you call it, but it's 25% Masham, 25% Romney's lamb's wool, 25% British alpaca, and 25% Blueface lesser. The Fabulous Four base. Fabulous Four is what it's called. It's a fingering weight to apply and it's non-superwash, and I can't wait to try this yarn. I don't know what to do with it, but I can't wait to try it. Yeah, this is pure teaswolf lamb's wool. It's not the same base, but they can be used together. I bought this from Modelon Yarns, and there is a pattern for like a gradient cowl, which I'm not going to make. I'm not sure what I'm going to make, but I just really like this idea. I think it's 520 gram skeins. The store, it says that 86 yards per 1 ounce skein. I'm not sure how much 1 ounce is in kilos or grams, but I bought that one. I bought these three, which I'm not sure what it's going to be. It's Ushitita. It's not really a yarn that, it's a single ply merino yarn, so it's not my most used, but these were really pretty. And I'm thinking I'm going to make a shawl with all of these three together. And I've been really wanting to make the Oracle shawl by Wool & Vine lately. But I'm not sure if this is too busy. I'm not sure. I'm thinking that this might be too busy for that shawl and I should choose something that's a little more tonal or something. I'm not sure. But these are going to be a shawl either from Wool & Vine or maybe a Steven West design, or I don't know. I have no idea actually. Talking about shawls, I also bought this lace yarn. It's 300 grams and I think this was like 28 pounds and it's from Woolmeise. And it's 300 grams of this gorgeous, I mean seriously check out this color. This is my color. And I'm not sure what to do with this, but I'm thinking a big circular shawl. Or a blanket. Or a cardigan. Or it's like, this is enough to do anything I want. It is 300 grams and 1575 meters. So this is enough for a sweater or a cardigan or anything. I bought a little bit more Woolmeise. I bought these three skeins of Woolmeise Twin, which is their sock yarn. And I'm thinking that this is going to be some sort of sweater or cardigan. And I bought this because I love this yarn for socks, so I bought this single skein, so this is going to be socks. It's just the stitch definition on this yarn is really good and it's really hard wearing, and some of the first socks that I knit was in Woolmeise and they are still hanging in there. They're still keeping up. And yeah, I bought traditional fair isle knitting because I really want to get more into fair isle. I've been doing lots of stranded knitting and I have the plans to knit next year in Lerwick, which is a fair isle pattern, and I have the yarns for that. But I really want to be able to make fair isle and choose the colors myself, because in fair isle there's very often lots of colors and I find it a little bit hard to put colors together when there are so many of them. So I want to figure that one out. And this one has an own section about colors in fair isle, and I think this will be really helpful. I also bought a Shetlandish fair isle graph book. Which is just basically, it's just a graph book really, and it's amazing. It looks like this. Just drawings. In color. So both of these two will be very helpful when I decide to start doing more fair isle. And I bought the alternate stitch dictionary. I bought all of these from Isolda's booth. And it's just like, it's a stitch dictionary, and I didn't really look that much in this before buying it. I put it up on a like random page, and I liked what I saw, so I bought it because at that time I was in full blown shopping mode. The one thing that I have bought that I have been using, besides my backpack, which I'm about to forget, this is the new backpack from Plystre Knitwear. And everyone is using their project bags, and I was planning to get that. And then the night before the festival, I had nothing that I was going to buy. But Wednesday night when I was in bed, I was checking out the hashtag for Edinburgh Yarn Festival at Instagram, and this one popped out and it was new. It's from Plystre Knitwear, a Norwegian lady who sews them. And I mean, the quality of this is really, really good. It's sturdy, it has pockets on the inside. It even has, it's really hard to see, but it has some pockets for the needles. Some pockets for yarns that has this this thing is. It has a bigger pocket in the back, which is awesome for holding patterns. And it has this one in the front. And this one is actually big enough that I can fit my phone in here. I can fit the camera, and I have like basically that's everything. Phone and camera, and I'm good to go. And I can put that in the front pocket, and I can fill up. I could fill up, and I did the rest of this backpack with things I bought. I have some pins because apparently I'm on that again. Yeah, I'm just going to show it like this. The other thing that I've been starting using. I bought a drops middle, and it's just like, I've had so much fun these last couple of days learning to use it. I bought this from Louise at Spin City, and it's just so pretty. And I've been spinning some yarn. I started yesterday, so I have to say that I'm quite pleased with this. The only trouble is that I didn't get much knitting time these last couple of days because, well, I was spinning instead. The fiber that I'm spinning on this is a Shetland fiber. I didn't buy this at the festival. I got this from Heidi Kim at the Norhokoa Gora. At the Knitting in the Midnight Sun retreat that we had in my hometown last summer. And it's she said it would be easy to spin, so I'm starting with that. And I've been checking out videos about spinning, and I started a crafty class, which I'm going to talk more about when I do a real episode. But I started a crafty class, I guess I'm a spinner now, which maybe that's why I'm hesitant to buy a loom, because maybe I should just really do the spinning before I start even another hobby. But it's like, I just want to do everything. It's just, I feel so over-inspired that at this point I could probably start doing anything. But I have been talking about wanting to learn to spin. So Catherine gave me these two big bags of wool. This is carded fibers from Masham Lamb's Wool. And this is carded fiber from the Romney Lamb's Wool. And in this one, there's also this pencil rowing, which is basically, it's unspun yarn, or rowing, it's really thin rowing. So that it's really good for beginner spinners, because you can make the twist in this yarn without worrying about the drafting, which makes it easier to do, because you can manage the spinning before you manage the drafting, basically. And I also bought from Louise at Spin City, where I bought the spindle, and she has so much pretty stuff that I'm definitely going back to her store later. I mean, seriously, look at this. This is just like, it's a night sky. It's just, this is amazing, and I haven't opened it, and I can't wait to figure out how to spin this, because I have no idea how to tackle that, but I know it will be okay. I got this one, homemade lavender balm from Anna of the Dental Green podcast. She made this herself. And very recently she did a podcast episode where she talked about making balm and making soaps. This has the lavender smell, and it's really good. And it's amazing. I can't believe she made this and I got one. I want to make them myself, but I know that I probably shouldn't get into like balm making and soap making and stuff. So I'm just not going to do that. So thank you, Anna. It was really nice meeting you and getting that. I got this from Patricia of Knitography. Okay, I didn't get them. I bought them. I bought them before we left, and she managed to finish them and bring them along. And seriously, look at this. These are mitten blockers, and I can't wait to use them. And she also brought along some bee butter, so that I can take care of my new mitten blockers. And this is her logo. And these are really good quality, and it's like, I know that they won't be ruined from using them, but I almost don't want to use them. I just want to put them up. I can hang them in my craft room just for show. But she makes this to size, so this is going to fit the mittens for my hand. But she has all of this on her website, how to order them and how to figure out which size you need. And she also, I think she does custom sizes if you need something else. And this bee butter is for putting on the wood so that the wood will hold up. In this house, everything that comes in this kind of tin probably tastes good. So Ludwig kind of ate it. Ludwig really loved it. He was so mad when I took it away from him. I haven't tasted it. I'm not going to, but it's like, yeah. Actually, this one is like beeswax, and it's beeswax which is local to her. And there is some Spanish olive oil, and there is one more thing in it, and I'm not sure, I don't remember what it was. But it's like, you can use it for sores and stuff as well, and I was really dry around my lips, so I put a little bit on there, and it actually got really much better just from that. I've been trying everything from pharmacies and stuff this last couple of weeks, but I used that 2 times, and everything was better. I think this and the blister backpack might be the favorite things that I brought home with me. Well, yeah, and this, which I can't believe that I have. This is from Woolen Vine Yarns. And this is on her footsie base, which is 80/20 super SPF L and nylon. It's a fingering weight, and it's just amazing. The color is Edinburgh, and she had brought a couple of these for gifting, and I got one, and I feel so honored. And yeah, it's like, can you believe this? I've been telling Kristin, I was telling her at the festival, that I admire Kristin so much. And one thing is, as a podcaster and a dyer, of course, seriously, look at this. Of course, I admire her dyeing skills. She is absolutely awesome. And she's also a great podcaster. She's one of the first ones that I watched. And she's so great in business as well. It's like, yeah, just the way she managed to make Woolen Vine Yarns as big as it is. And it's just, it's amazing, and she's such a nice person, and I really hope that I will get to meet her again someday soon, because yeah, now I'm just repeating myself, she's really lovely. And the last gift that I'm going to show you is this one from Craft Nutrients, more from her. It's these water tunnels. So that's basically the same one as this. Yeah. And there is some miniskein. So basically, I think I can use all of these together for something, but I'm not sure what. And this is really specially owned because, yeah, it's from Catherine. So I need to find the perfect project, but it's so amazing that I have a mini skein, because then I can mix and match a little bit. And I think I could probably use this together with some of my hand dyed, or some finul or something like that. Yeah. I bought some Jameson's Shetland Spindrift, and I'm not sure what happened here, because this is what I came home with, and this is not what I was planning on going home with, because I thought that I have bought 2 black, 2 greys, and 2 yellows, but I have 3 blacks, 2 greys, and 1 yellow. So now my plans for this yarn didn't go, I won't be able to make what I had planned to make from this yarn. But I think I will manage to use it anyway. It's a fingering weight rustic Shetland wool. And everyone's been trying this yarn, so this is one of those, like, everyone has been trying it. I just really want to try it, because everyone else, I just want to compare it to, like, the finul and stuff. I also bought this from Eden Cottage Yarn, which is going to be a shawl, I think. This is just, it's my color. It is, I don't even know what I've been buying. It's Milburn Fur Ply. It's 85% blue face leather and 15% silk. 50 grams is 200 meters, so it's a fingering weight. And I have 3, so I have 150 meters, which is going to be, give me a big shawl, I think. Oh, not like a huge big shawl, but big enough. and this is my color. So I was in shawl mode, I think, one of the days because I had lots of shawl on, which is, I haven't been eating shawls in a long time, so it sucks it. The last thing that I bought is, and this is a sweaters quantity, I bought this from Martin's Lab. It's a 2-ply, 100% wool yarn, 400 meters in 100 grams of fingering weight, and I'm not sure what to make from this, but it's going to be some sort of a garment, and I think I'm going to keep it undyed. I'm not going to dye this yarn, I'm just going to make myself a grey garment, and maybe if I want to do some... So, that's it. I think that's everything I bought, and yeah, I need to figure out where to put my spinning stuff, because I have lots of spinning stuff and I have no room for it. I need to go upstairs to clean my craft room a little bit and start stashing these all my new babies into Ravelry and put them on their on the shelves where they are supposed to live for now. And yeah, I will do another episode in not very long. I'm just looking at all my stuff. I will do another episode in not very long, and then I will show you what I was knitting on while on the festival and what I have finished since the last time and all that stuff. I just figured that I wouldn't be doing that today just because, well, you see, I didn't really have time. But it was really nice talking with you, and I hope that you will hit the thumbs up button and the subscribe button if you liked this podcast. And if you didn't, then I don't really get why you're still here. Feel free to move along. And I just wanted to say a huge, yet another again, thank you to everyone who made Edinburgh so awesome. I'm definitely going back next year. I'm hoping to do Ryan back, and I'm hoping to do Vogue Knitting Live, and I'm hoping to do everything. I hope that I will win a lottery so that I have the money to do everything. And it's like, I've been talking about, should I sell my house to buy yarns? Or should I buy a bigger house to have room for my yarns? It's like, you can't decide. Anyway, I will talk with you again, hopefully in a week. And yeah, until then, I hope that you have a really crafty week, and that you will hop on over to the Ravelry group and share what you're working on. And bye.